Bob and Todd were brothers. One day, Bob said, "Todd, I'm going down to the bog."
"The bog?"
asked Todd. "Yes, the bog, Todd," said Bob.
"But Bob,"
said Todd,
"not the bog. The bog is bad."
"It's not a bad bog," said Bob. "It's just a bog. And besides, there are logs in the bog, and we need logs."
"But Bob,"
said Todd,
"those logs are soggy. Soggy bog logs won't burn. And what about the glop?"
"What glop?" asked Bob.
"Bob, the bog is full of glop. You'll get bog glop on your clogs if you go looking for logs."
"Well, I'm going anyway," said Bob, as he pulled on his clogs.
"But Bob,"
blurted Todd,
"there are bugs in the bog."
"Bugs?" asked Bob.
"Bugs, big bugs, big bog bugs,"
said Todd. "Big bog bugs?" asked Bob.
"Big biting bog bugs,"
said Todd.
"Don't go to the bog, Bob."
Bob scratched his head. "Ah," he said, "but Todd, there are also frogs in the bog."
"Frogs?"
asked Todd. "Frogs. There are mobs of frogs. And toads too, Todd. The toads and frogs will gobble the big biting bog bugs, and I'll get some logs."
"But Bob,"
begged Todd,
"the bog is bad. There are slugs in the bog. Ugly bog slugs."
"Oh, Todd," said Bob, "I'm not afraid of ugly bog slugs. Besides, I'll bring a jug for the slugs. I'll slip the ugly bog slugs into the jug. The toads and frogs will gobble the big biting bog bugs, and I'll bring back some logs."
"Soggy logs,"
said Todd. "Whatever," said Bob. So Bob started out the door. He picked up a jug for the slugs. "Ta-ta, Todd," said Bob.
"Bob," blurted Todd. "Bob, stop."
"What is it now?"
barked Bob.
"I almost forgot. The hobgoblin."
"Hobgoblin?"
"Yes, Bob. The hobgoblin that lives in the bog. He guards the plug."
"What plug?" asked Bob.
"The bog plug," said Todd. "There's a plug in the bog like in a tub. The hobgoblin guards the plug."
"Why?" asked Bob.
"Because if someone were to tug on the plug, all the glop in the bog would go glug, glug, glug. And the hobgoblin loves that bog glop."
Bob scratched his chin and thought for a minute.
"Todd," Bob shouted, "I must go to the bog."
"What?" said Todd. "After all I've told you?"
"Yes," said Bob. "Don't you see? I'll jog down to the bog through the glop in my clogs. The toads and frogs will gobble the big biting bog bugs. I'll slip the ugly bog slugs into the slug jug. I'll tug the plug. All the glop in the bog will go glug, 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 and we can finally have dry bog logs."
"It sounds simple when you say it,"
said Todd.
"But what about the hobgoblin?"
"I'll bop him," said Bob. "I'll bop him right on his hobgoblin noggin."
"Bob, Bob, Bob,"
said Todd.
"You think you can just bop a hobgoblin? You'll get clobbered."
"We'll see," said Bob. And off he went. He jogged to the bog. He slogged through the glop in his clogs, watching the toads and frogs gobbling the big biting bog bugs.
"Good job, frogs," said Bob with a nod.
When an ugly slug slithered onto one of his clogs, Bob slipped it into the slug jug.
"This bog's not so bad," said Bob.
As he was looking in the glop for logs, Bob spotted the bog plug. He set down the slug jug and began to tug on the plug.
"Ugh,"
Bob grumbled.
"This plug is too snug."
Just then, Bob heard a noise. "That's odd," thought Bob. He turned around, and there, knee-deep in the bog glop, it was the hobgoblin. Bob was shocked and shook in his clogs. He searched for a log, but all he could find was the slug jug, so he picked it up to bop the hobgoblin on the noggin. And then a strange thing happened. The hobgoblin started to sob. He sobbed, and he sobbed, and he sobbed. Bob had never seen a hobgoblin sobbing.
"Oh, why does everyone want to bop me on the noggin?"
the hobgoblin slobbered.
"And why have you got Doug in a jug?"
"Doug?" asked Bob, looking into the jug.
"Yes, Doug. He's my slug,"
hollered the hobgoblin. "Stop sobbing, hobgoblin," said Bob as he slipped the slug Doug from the jug. "Here's your slug."
Thank you, sniffed the hobgoblin. And why were you tugging on the plug?
To drain the glop from the bog, said Bob. It makes the bog logs soggy, and soggy bog logs won't burn.
Not by a long shot, said the hobgoblin. But you can't just run roughshod through the glop in your clogs, slipping slugs into jugs and tugging on plugs.
Why not? Asked Bob.
Because, the hobgoblin howled, if you tugged that plug and didn't stop till it popped, all the glop in the bog would go glug, 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 and the slugs would go glug, and the frogs would go glug, and the toads too, and the big biting bog bugs, and the soggy bog logs, and you and me and Doug, every last one of us, glug, glug, glug.
Gosh, said Bob, that's horrible.
Horrible, said the hobgoblin. But if you really want to blot out the bog, go ahead. Tug the plug.
I just want some logs, sighed Bob.
Well, why didn't you say so?
Said the hobgoblin. He leaned over and whispered into Bob's ear. Aha! Cried Bob. Thank you, hobgoblin. He kicked up his clogs and jogged out of the bog and all the way home. Todd! Todd! I'm back from the bog! Where are the soggy bog logs? Asked Todd. We'll never need them again, said Bob. Come with me! He grabbed Todd and darted out the door.
Where are we going? Asked Todd.
To the woods, Todd! To the woods! Said Bob.
The woods? Cried Todd. Not the woods! The woods are no good! The woods are full of hoods. Oh, the woods are no good. The woods are full of hoods.
Todd,
I mean,
be quiet.
We could go to the woods, but they're all full of hoods.
All right,
we could go
to
the lake.
We don't
but
have
the
to
lake
go.
Is all full of snakes.
Forget it.
And there's no cake in the
Todd.
Lake. I mean, why would we go to the lake? There's
Todd,
no
never,
cake and it's
mind.
All full of snakes.
We could go to the
We'll
the,
stay
the
forest, but
Todd.
Nothing rhymes with that. We could go to the desert or the city or the plains. Or, I don't know.